Where's the charger? Okay.
Today again, if you missed it, a record for the date. Hottest ever in June. 103 now, and that humidity looks low, but remember, the hotter the air is, the more moisture it can hold. So 103 with 31% humidity is a lot more humid than, say, 73 with 31% humidity. And it is muggy out there.
Mr. Toad?
Oh, shit. Bigby! Listen, mate, I know I don't look human. It's a problem, I get it. I just stepped out the apartment for just a second to see what kind of damage this drunk shit is doing. Just cut me a break, yeah?
Toad?
I'll get me glamour first thing in the morning. Cross my arm. No need to kick up a fuss.
I've heard enough of your excuses, Toad. This is unacceptable. If you can't afford to look human, you're going to the farm. It's as simple as that.
You can't send me up to live with those animals. You know what I mean.
Go see a witch. Get a glamour.
Bigby, they're bleeding me dry, mate. The quality of the spout goes down, but the rates keep climbing up. Do you have any idea how much it costs to have an entire family in glamour?
I don't make the rules. Sorry. I can't give you a free pass on this, Toad. My hands are tied.
Right.
Huh. Wait, how about is there... I didn't even do that thing about me. There it is.
Sheriff, you're just gonna stand there? Do something, Bigby, before he completely tears up the place.
I should probably go handle this.
Yes, please. Thank you. Third prick got shite. Tell me how to spend my money.
Dad, the lights are shaking again.
What did I say? You want a big bad wolf to take you away?
No.
Then get the fuck back inside.
Oh, damn.
You're gonna know who I fucking am, you hear me? Hey, look at me!
Stop, okay? You're drunk! Let go!
Take a look. Take a good look. Know who I am now? Hey, look at me!
Anything over here? I'm banging in.
Damn you! No way!
Whoa, hey!
You've got something on your face.
Fuck are you talking about, you stupid cunt?
All right, what's going on here?
Oh.
What are you gonna fucking do, huh? Get the fuck out of the way before you get the axe again.
Woody, this is your last warning. If you keep on like this, I won't have any choice but to put you down.
Put me down? You got a shit fucking memory, Wolf. That's not how it went last time.
This isn't last time. You should probably get out of here.
Look, I'm not leaving until I get what's mine.
You're not getting shit, bitch. I'll fucking put you in the ground.
Shut up.
Oh, fucking shit. You bogged my jaw, you bastard.
And still you talk.
Fuck you.
Shit.
What are you doing here?
These lips are sealed. Look, this is just the start of a shitty night for me. I just need the money he owes me, then I can go.
All right. You need to go.
I can't go until this deadbeat pays me.
For what?
I let you slap me around for a while. You're lucky I'm not charging extra.
Why was he hitting you?
Maybe you should ask him that.
I will, but I asked you first.
He asked me if I recognized him, knew who he was. I said I didn't. He started beating on me. Then you showed up, started beating on him. Thought about cover it, hon?
I'm the Woodsman, you whore. I saved Little Red Riding Hood from this monster. I cut this fucker open and filled his belly full of stones! And threw him in the fucking river. That's who the fuck I am, you stupid bitch!
Hey, what did I say? I said be nice, or you wait outside.
Come on!
Am I dead? Of course not. Where'd he go?
Ah, shit. Hey, Toad.
My car.
Yeah. Give me a second.
Oh, no, by all means. Take your time. Make yourself comfortable.
So, how good is your insurance?
I can't be mad at you. I called you. And you come to help. I can't be made. But even when you help,
things end up more fucked than they started.
Well, at least you're not fucking dead.
He's still walking. Is he not human? Oh.
Thanks.
Don't mention it. I'm just getting what he owes me. You all right back there? I mean, your eyes and the teeth. You're not really supposed to do that, are you?
Not if I can avoid it.
Great.
The guy's got an axe in his brain. He's not feeling that.
It's more from me. He'll be fine.
I'll kill you, you fucking bitch.
Let me help you.
Guy's having a bad day.
That makes two of us. I guess it's a good thing fables are hard to kill.
Suppose it is.
Thanks.
If you guys are joining the stream, please do not forget to leave a follow. If you already follow, thank you for watching.
Who do you
and
work
sorry, I haven't been on in a while. Just never really in the mood for it.
These lips
it.
Are sealed. Sorry. Hey, you like my ribbon?
Don't answer my questions. I can't help you.
I'm answering them the best that I can.
I feel like we've met before.
We probably have. We all sort of knew each other at one point or another. But things change, I guess.
I guess.
He's gone.
Shit.
Stop. We don't have to make any more of a thing out of it than it already is.
Are you sure?
He's had enough. For tonight, at least. Wouldn't be surprised if he has an axe to grind, though. That wasn't intentional. Sorry.
Was it he owed you?
100.
I'm guessing it'd be bad for you to show up empty-handed.
I'll be fine.
I really wish I could help.
It's okay. I'll be fine. You've done enough, really. You got me out of a bad situation back there. Thanks.
I'm still gonna need a statement.
I have to go drop off what I have.
Meet me back at my office, then.
It's a little late for an office visit, Sheriff. I'll swing by your apartment.
He's a sheriff?
You know where I am.
You live in the smallest apartment in the Woodlands. Everyone knows that.
Good to know.
You should get cleaned up. You look like shit. And I don't use that term lightly. Some of these look pretty bad.
I clean up okay.
I'll believe it when I see it. Hey. I need to tell you something.
What is it?
You're not as bad as everyone says you are.
Ooh, little slut.
I'll see you around, Wolf.
Oh, this ends just like right there. Welcome to Fable Town. I'll be back in a minute.
Luxury apartments. Wish they wouldn't advertise that.
Stalker.
There's no walking on the grass, no White's orders. She made a sign and everything.
I'll be sure to send her an apology.
Beauty.
Hello, Big B. I wasn't expecting anyone. I know this looks a little odd. But there's an explanation, I swear.
You're out pretty late.
Is there some sort of curfew I don't know about? For the third degree. Damn it, I'm late. Please, Bigby. Promise me you won't tell Beast you saw me. He worries too much as it is, and... it would just make my life a lot easier.
Look, whatever it is, it's between you and Beast. I'm staying out of it.
I don't have time to go into it right now. I'll explain it all to you later. I will, but I have to go.
even know these people?
It's not what you might be thinking.
Hey, you wink? Probably for the best.
Guy still doesn't wake up, man.
Been a while since I got any mail. Seventh day in a row.
Hey, there's one all scratching off.
Bigby, hey, wait up. Have you seen my wife? Have you seen Beauty?
Nope, haven't seen her.
Oh, okay. Sorry to bother you. Damn it, something's going on.
Damn, I should have told you. I'm gonna be a snitch next time. Good man. I am a good man. Ow. Dang.
Damn. Should have cracked a window.
Was it hot in here? It's either hot in here or it smells really bad. But it smells really bad.
What a night.
Freezer, refrigerator.
Why do I even own this? Should have got a smaller one.
Dude, you're not organized.
Bluebeard's file. Never trusted this guy. Don't even remember ordering that. Probably a bad sign. Hey, Colin, get up.
Huh. Hey, Big B.
Oh, he's a guy. I thought he was his pet.
I'm in your chair, huh?
I've only got the one. So, yeah.
Thank you.
Got a smoke?
What?
Thanks. Couple thousand more of these, we'll be even on that house you owe me.
This has gotta stop. You can't keep sneaking off the farm like this.
The fresh air and sunshine pitch they sell you on is bullshit. I didn't escape out of the homelands to end up in some prison, okay? Don't send me back there, Bigby. You don't know what it's like, okay? You haven't been there.
Don't be a pain in the ass. I'll tell you what I told Toad.
And what's that?
I can't give you a free pass.
Lectured by the big bad wolf. He must have loved that.
That for me?
Nope.
The house didn't blow itself down, Bigby. That's all I'm saying. Do with that what you will. Now, I'm not saying it's reason enough for me to have definitely been offered a drink, but, it would have helped ease some of the pain you once caused me, yes? It also would have shown everyone how different you are now.
If that was all you were saying, I'd be able to get some rest.
I take it all back. This is why everyone hates you.
It is better to be feared than loved. You know who said that?
Yeah, some sad asshole. Eating alone. But, hate's the wrong word. They fear you more than anything. You ate a lot of people back in your day.
I thought we were all supposed to have a fresh start here. I can't change the past.
Well, you can't change people's memories either. Look, I'm not saying it's fair, but it's real. People are scared of you. I mean, look at your hands. Who'd you get in a fight with? A fable, right? I'm sure you're not going around punching Mondays.
Wasn't my fault.
I get the impression you say that a lot.
You think my job is easy? You try keeping a bunch of fables from killing each other. How do you think this all works?
I don't know. How?
By being big and being bad.
By being big and being bad. Don't say that shit in front of people. It's embarrassing. That's the attitude that gets you in trouble. I'm sure you were shitty to everyone you came across tonight.
Not everyone.
Name one.
I don't actually know her name.
Awesome. Great example. Life is easier with friends, Bigby. And we live a long fucking time. I know you like this whole lone wolf thing you got going for yourself. But I've seen the way you look at Snow, okay? You're not fooling me.
Will you shut up?
Well, maybe if my throat wasn't so parched, I wouldn't have to keep talking.
Wait, that doesn't make
sense. Just give me a drink, please.
Colin, enough already. I haven't slept in 2 days. I went out a second-story window and I want to get in 2 seconds of shut-eye before I... Look, if I give you this, will you let me sleep?
Yeah, all right. Probably. Thanks, Bigby.
Bigby!
Snow?
Come with me.
Snow?
What? Sorry, I'm
What is it?
What happened?
I just can't get into it this second. We need to hurry to...
Hi.
Hello. Good morning. Or evening.
Yeah.
These walls are paper thin. We need to be careful. We'll talk outside. You knew this girl? She's not a Mundy, right? Who was she? I thought I knew everyone in Fabletown. She looks familiar. I can't place her, though.
Just a girl. We didn't have a whole lot of time to chat. The woodsman. He attacked her, I stepped in. And he threatened to kill us both.
No, you don't think he...
I don't think anything yet. Just give me a second.
It's just... terrible.
So, did you see anyone else?
No, no one.
No cabs, no voices, Mundys?
Maybe, but... no, I don't think so. I would remember.
Okay.
Bigby, did one of us do this?
There hasn't been a murder in Fabletown in a long time.
All the more reason we shouldn't start a panic before we know what's going on. I'll have a look around. We don't have much time before people will be coming through here. Could do something like that.
Either something very sharp or something with magic attached to it. What is? It's her ribbon. There's some kind of symbol here.
I don't recognize it.
Neither do I. She was placed here with some care.
What do you mean?
You can see that someone didn't just toss her here. She was deliberately placed for us to find.
What kind of monster would do this? I'm sorry. This is just so surreal. What do you want to do next?
We still have some time. I should keep investigating the area.
Okay, good idea.
Blood. Drops of blood. I'd say it's been here an hour, maybe? Hmm.
genes. Doesn't tell me much. Blood. Still wet. Sharp enough. Yep, more blood. Someone might have hopped the fence, got caught, then left the trail I found earlier. Just some loose trash. Nobody there.
What are you doing?
Better to be thorough.
Sure, just hurry up. We don't have much time. We should move her before anyone shows up. We'll find out more at the business office. She'll be in the books. I'm sure of it. Bigby, do you have any idea what's going on? How did this happen? Why her?
This is a message.
A message? I don't know, Bigby. I get complaints at the office all the time, but just what about this makes you think that?
The victim. She could be a symbol for something.
I'm gonna have to tell Crane about this. As long as King Cole is gone, he's acting mayor. He needs to know. And he's going to find out anyway, so we may as well get out in front of it.
I guess it's useless to drag it out.
That's how I feel too. I'm sure he won't be happy, but it's just part of the process. Hopefully he can be rational about it.
I wouldn't hold my breath.
I'm not.
I just don't want him interfering.
Crane's not what's important right now. We need to figure out who this girl was so we can find whoever did this. Take this back to Dr. Swinehart. He can take a look at it. I'll meet you at the business office.
What are you, blind? What, you don't see there's a line? I've been standing here a half hour already. You get to just walk in? Must be nice being the sheriff. Do whatever the fuck you like.
I work here.
And what great work you do, sheriff.
That didn't feel very genuine.
Fucker.
Because you are the one bringing this to me, Miss Snow. The one who so simply stumbled upon this catastrophe on our very doorstep. The last thing I need with Mayor Cole away is a hysteria. Do you understand me?
Yes, of course I do.
Don't interrupt me, Miss Snow.
You asked me a question.
Don't change the subject. You are to blame for this unpleasantness, Miss Snow.
I brought you this news as soon as I could.
You are trusted to keep things running smoothly around here. This is a disaster.
It isn't anyone's fault. Instead of trying to assign blame, maybe we should figure out how to catch the fucker who did this.
Oh, is that how you see things? Sheriff, you are the one charged with protecting the citizens of Fabletown. Your failure to do so cost someone their life and the safety of the entire community. Tell me you've been doing something. Are there any leads? Suspects? Anything. Anything at all. Any shred of evidence you two know what the hell you're doing.
The woodsman is a person of interest. From what we've been able to gather, he was last seen with the victim.
The woodsman? That drunk wretch was the cause of this?
It's a lead. Nothing certain yet.
Well, find him. Get him in here if that's all you have to go on. You two need to get a handle on this situation quickly and quietly. The last thing we need is all of Fabletown knowing there's a killer amongst us. Snow.
Yes? Sir?
Call Vivian right this minute and let her know I'm coming in early for my massage.
I will.
Where is the bottle of wine you were to purchase? Don't bother. Forget it. Can't do anything right. Do your job, Sheriff. Or we'll find someone who can.
You know what?
Stop. We'll get on it right away, sir. You would have just pissed him off more.
All right.
Well, that could have gone better. Well, maybe we should have dragged it out.
For what it's worth, I still think it was better to tell him.
Yeah, maybe. Oh, Crane doesn't like people smoking and... Never mind. Smoke away.
Who gets a massage this early?
Crane. It doesn't really matter the time of day. A mere scent of stress and he's out the door.
Is he gone?
Yes, thankfully. Buffkin!
Hello, Miss Snow.
Drinking? This early? Where did you get that?
It was by Mr. Ichabod's desk.
Then don't you think it probably belongs to him?
Maybe. How are you today, Mr. Bigby?
It hasn't been a great morning, Buffkin.
Sorry.
Eh, not your fault. Thanks for asking, though.
Buffkin, get the books.
Which books?
The ones with all the fables in it.
Not sure that was any more specific.
Bring the first three.
Be back in a few minutes.
He knows the ones I'm talking about. There's bound to be information on her here. Somewhere. We'll at least be able to get her real name from the books whenever Buffkin finds them. In the meantime, poke around. Maybe the mirror can help. I really have to get this appointment squared away, but let me know if you need anything. Hello, Vivian? Hi, this is Snow White, Mr. Crane.
Worth a try. Hey, Magic Mirror. I got a question.
You know the rule.
I don't have time for this shit.
Your impatience is callow. You're needlessly cruel. But have some respect for our history of rules.
Mirror, mirror. If you're able, tell me all about this fable.
See? Was that so hard?
Yeah, I'm about 2 seconds away from kicking a hole in you.
There's no need for that. Fine. Of which fable do you wish to know?
Show me the woodsman. Where is he?
What you see is complete. The woodsman stumbles down a street.
No shit. Which street?
I'm sorry, Bigby. I can only show you what can be seen.
Show me Snow White.
Not much of a request. She's in this very room.
Show me Buffkin. Hey, put down the bottle and get to work.
Still looking!
well. Please return should you wish to ask about someone else. Or someone new.
Well, I'm sure we'll get it all cleared up. Okay. Thank you.
What?
I can't read any of this shit.
I can help.
Yeah, thanks.
We look out for each other.
Don't overdo it. Bufkin, translate.
An exquisite design from the good china of Toad Hall.
Mr. Toad?
He probably wrote this in himself.
What's it say about?
It says Bricklebit in an older elfish hand.
What's Bricklebit?
A magic word.
What's it do?
Makes animals shit gold.
This looks familiar.
Yes, from the Axe of the Woodsman, a druid blessing, actually.
Someone blessed that thing?
I only translate.
What's that?
It reads, Mark of the House of the Frog Prince.
Not quite who I'm looking for. This is the one. Where is this symbol from? Which family or story?
That's an odd one. Family name? Alerlairau? I'll go look it up.
Alelaira. That means every kind of fur in German.
Donkey skin.
Yes. What does it say?
Donkey skin girl, also known as donkey skin. Also known as... ass skin. prefers to go by the name Faith. Poetic?
Bufkin, we don't need the commentary.
The story of donkey skin. There was once a great king with a beautiful queen. The queen grew ill and had her husband promise to only marry the most beautiful girl in the kingdom. After a long search, it became clear that the only woman in the land that could match her beauty was... his daughter, Faith. She had a magic cloak made from the skin of her father's prized donkey that would hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom. Eventually, she married a prince who could see past the magic cloak and knew her true beauty. And they lived happily ever after. Should I mark it, Miss Snow?
Yes. Please. And what's her husband's name?
Lawrence. Prince Lawrence.
We got what we came for.
Yeah.
Her name's Faith. She was married to Prince Lawrence. I mean, that's more than
her name was Faith.
Yeah.
We should talk to the husband.
You think he did it?
With this sort of thing, it's usually the person who knew them best.
Or it's someone completely random. Any information on fables in our community will be somewhere in these books. We already know her name, but feel free to have a look if you like.
Beauty in happier days. I think her name was Red. She didn't make it out. Red Riding Hood's knight in shabby armor.
The woodsman?
Yep, and his axe. And there's me. Had a good day.
I'm pretty sure that's supposed to be me.
Yeah, dwarves. Less said about that, the better. Beast. Colin and his brothers. Yeah, that's her, all right. A long time ago. Ichabod Crane. Scared shitless.
What's that?
Your boss. His finest moment. Hard to understand how he ended up running this place.
Well, maybe it's time that changed.
I haven't seen Badger around for a while.
He likes his privacy, I think.
I wish Toad would like his a bit more. Nice hat. Strength. I guess it comes in all forms. Mirror, mirror, blah, blah, able, blah, blah, blah about this fable.
Of which fable do you wish to know?
He's a prince, I think. Show me Prince Lawrence. What's he been doing? Where is this?
Where's what?
Do you know where Prince Lawrence lives?
If he's a prince, probably relocated in the South Bronx. Yellow building, red window shutters.
Red frames.
Yep, that's the one. I can take us there.
Show me Faith's father, the old king. Guess that crosses him off the suspect list. Show me Faith.
Through powerful magic, her whereabouts concealed. Unfortunately for you, these lips are sealed.
What?
These lips are sealed. It's not my choice of phrasing, Ruby. It's simply the way this has to be.
Nobody right now.
Anything we can use?
Yeah, that'll have to do for now.
Come on, we're going over there. Sorry, I have to get that. Hello, Woodlands Business Office. Yes, he is. Hold on. Bigby, it's for you.
Bigby, it's me, Toad. You there?
What do you want?
Bigby, shit. Listen, right, there's a bloke upstairs going through all the woodsman's things. Get over here, Bigby, before he... Oh, wait, hang on. Oi! Shit! Hey!
What was that about?
Hard to say. Something going on over at Toad's place.
What about Faith's husband?
I don't know, I couldn't really tell. But he could be in trouble. And we should go there anyway to search her apartment. Toad might have to wait.
Whenever you're ready. Did Toad say who was there? Was it the woodsman?
I don't know. It's possible. Whoever it was, it didn't seem like Toad was happy to see him.
Well,
Maybe Prince Lawrence can wait.
Yeah, he didn't see him. He could use some help, too.
Well, where to first?
Bigby! Shit! Listen, right? There's a bloke upstairs going through all the woodsman's things.
You think he did it? What's her husband's name?
Lawrence. Prince Lawrence.
Toad sounds like he needs help right now. We can check in on Prince Lawrence after.
Okay. I'm not looking forward to breaking the news to him anyway.
And we ended up going out the window, and I landed on Toad's car.
You guys made a real mess.
Yeah. Looks worse in the day.
Is somebody up there?
Hey! Wait here.
I'm sorry.
That's enough, all right? Just shut it.
Is that his son?
Toads, I think.
Be nice in there, okay?
Bigby!
And Miss White!
Surely you didn't come all this way just for my bother. Sorry, Bigby. It's embarrassing to have to admit, but I thought there was someone else in Woody's place.
There wasn't, though. Not when I checked. Nothing but a leaky drain pipe. Imagination must have got the best of me.
So, you know, false alarm. Sorry for dragging Miss White into this.
There was someone, but they took off when we got here.
Is that right? I guess your dad's ears have a year or two left. Haven't gone totally to the dogs, eh?
Are you all right?
Oh, he's fine, Miss White. Just stung his little toe. Better swimmer than Walker, just like his dad.
Wanna?
So, I guess you'll be taking off now. No need to hang around here anymore. I mean, I'm sorry you came all the way here for nothing.
Someone was here, and something's going on. And just so this trip wasn't a complete waste of time, I'm gonna look around a bit before we leave, okay? The longer you talk, the longer this takes, so just stand over there and shut up.
All right. I just don't want to waste your time, is all. Have a seat. Have a cup of tea. Whatever you like.
Phew. Grown-ups. Am I right? Hey, you know what? Flycatcher said you had a pretty awesome insect collection. I'd really love to see it. Is it in your room?
It has a weevil.
Cool.
Just mind the upholstery while you're looking for nothing.
Yeah, sure thing. How'd this happen?
Fucking hell. Damn thing must have fell off a table.
Uh-huh. The lamp just fell off the table.
Well, the boy was faffing about, playing salts and saltfish. Who knows with the lad?
bleeding?
Why? Is that
blood? Still fresh.
Oh, well, I cut me hand. Ran around like a tit trying to pick out a wrap. Must have got some on the furnishments. Lamp in pieces, blood on the wall. It's awful, I know.
Sounds painful.
Oi! Don't you go mothering now. The wound didn't sit very long, you know. Perks of being a fable, I suppose. And a frog.
More blood over here.
On the poker?
Yeah. What happened?
Oh, well, that's how it happened, didn't it? I was poking the coals and it slipped a bit. Sliced up in my foot like a seashell. Looked like a shit ugly thing. If you're gonna say something, out with it.
It's been the hottest summer in years, Toad, so why would you be making a fire?
Stay in this place for more than a spell and a drought will make you think you're in a salting tundra. I look it odd, so what's a fuss?
I thought toads can dry out.
No, mate, you're thinking of lizards. Oh my god, will you not make a big faff out of this? There's nothing to solve here, Sheriff. I'm telling you everything that happened. Why don't you believe me? I mean, things happen, you know.
I think maybe you're hiding something.
Hiding something?
Maybe. But, to tell you the truth, I don't know yet. But I know you're lying about something.
But I'm not...
And you're just gonna make it worse for yourself the longer you keep up the act.
I'm not bullshitting you. Honest.
We'll see.
What is it now? If it's blood, you know what happened, I...
No, there's marks here on the windowsill. And what's that about?
No real reason. Just last night, when I'd come out, I was in a downright dizzy, mate, as you would be. And I plumb forgot the keys to this place. And I had to climb in through the bloody window.
Really?
Scared Junior off to death. Place needs a bit of dusting, I suppose.
I know something's off here, Toad. And I know I can't leave until I find out why. So can we please just skip to the end of the page before I have to get mean?
I don't know what you want, Bigby. There's nothing going on. There's just nothing to tell. Look around the room and see for yourself. Everything has its explanation, you'll see.
Honestly, Toad, I don't know if I will. And I don't know if I've got the patience to reverse engineer whatever scheme this is.
Me boy's in the other room, Bigby. Come on now. We're friends, right?
Down, Jesus!
You're gonna tell me, right now, what the fuck happened before we showed up.
Bigby,
If it even has the faintest whiff of bullshit, I'm gonna...
Dad! Bigby, is this really necessary?
Oh.
He's hiding something. Either something he knows or something he's kept, but I won't play any more games with him.
Dad? Oh my god.
Take off your hat.
Bigby, you didn't...
He didn't. It was that... Butcher, a Tweedle, Damodee. You gotta strip him down to the Johnnies before you can tell which is which. They come barging in, screaming about something a woodsman had. Or footy had, I don't know. He tore up the place, beat me up when I said I didn't have it. I tried to go out the window, but he pulled me back in.
You know where the Tweedle went?
No, he didn't happen to mention his nightly plans while he was busy braining me. Sorry.
I would have told you. I wanted to, really, I did. But he said if word of this ever got back to him, if he ever thought you knew, or Miss White, he'd come back and kill my boy. I even tried to give the bastard a coat. He wouldn't take it.
Who's GTA?
The girl.
Dad borrows things from people who live here. Sometimes.
Borrows?
I don't steal nothing. Turn around here would astonish you, mate. I merely repossess what's been left behind.
Well, we'll be taking the coat now. If she has next of kin, family, anyone.
All right. Fetch him the fur. Fine bit of dress it is. Now I wouldn't wear it outside.
Wait. It's an envelope.
Fucking hell, of course there is. For my luck, it's a map to some bloody doubloons.
It's addressed to Prince Lawrence. Do you want to try and give it to him, or...?
I'm sorry, Faith.
What could she have been sorry for?
I don't know. Maybe Lawrence does.
Well, it's been quite a surprising day for all of us, hasn't it? I'd see you out, but I'm afraid of dripping any more blood in the place.
It was very nice talking to you, TJ.
Thanks. See ya.
I'll be honest, Bigby, I don't really know how to feel about what happened in there.
We got what we came for. Some information. It'll be all right.
So, the prince is now?
Lawrence's, yeah. It's our best lead.
Our only lead, really.
When you put it that way.
I don't want to stay here any longer than we have to, so let's just pick an approach and stick to it, okay? Just humor me.
We're here to question Lawrence, bump him up on the suspect list, or cross him off entirely.
Okay.
What is it?
I just don't think he did it.
In cases like these, isn't it usually the husband?
For Mondays, maybe, but this is different. Oh my God.
Hey, stay with me, Lawrence. Gonna be all right.
No. Let me go. She.
What is it that you're telling us? Bigby, water. Kitchen. If you have something to ask him, you should do it now.
Who did this to you?
Faith.
Do you still have that letter?
Yes.
It's only two words, but he died without seeing them. I'm sorry. We need to figure out what happened here and find whoever did this.
Mirror showed me this. Maybe I should have come here first. It's sharp. There's blood on the blade.
I just don't understand. Why would someone want to kill him?
Still a little sticky. Stuck to the bed a little. My dearest Faith, I never meant to hurt you, and I cannot endure knowing that I have. This was for the best. I'll see you again. Love, your devoted Lawrence.
Hopefully they're together now.
About all we can hope for at this point.
When do you think that was taken?
Before all this. Stay here!
No!
Stop!
Leave me alone!
Ugh!
Ease up, Bigby. We're on the same side here.
You son of a bitch. Make me run after you. What were you doing back there?
Had some questions for Larry. Didn't think it'd go how it did.
A man's dead.
I know how it looks, but I had nothing to do with that.
Come on. I'm bringing you in.
What? Why?
Questioning.
Look, I was just asking him about the girl. That's all. When I mentioned her being dead, he freaked out. I figured someone had told him. How was I supposed to know? Shit. Fucker shot himself right in front of me. I couldn't stop him, man. Cool. Woodsman, right? I know where he is. My guy says he's holed up at the Trip Trap. We can go over there right now, the both of us. My employer's looking to ask him a few questions, too.
Who are you exactly?
I'm Dee, and I'm a private investigator. There's a business card in my shirt pocket. You can see for yourself.
This is for a sandwich shop.
Really? Huh. Must have run out.
Who hired you?
I can't tell you that. It's confidential. Sorry. Sure you understand.
Nope. Can't say that I do. Come on. You're coming with me.
This could have been easy.
Oh, don't worry. It still is. Come on.
Dumb.
Dumb? Yeah, it is. Look, it'd be much easier for you
to... No. I'm D. He's dumb.
You almost looked peaceful.
Yep.
Except you're lying in a dirty alley.
Yep.
With an open wound on the back of your head.
Yep. Where'd they go?
Well, after the one guy hit you, and the other one finished kicking you...
That explains the ribs.
Then they jumped into a car and drove off. Come on, get up. Guess we're out of options.
Dee mentioned the Trip Trap.
Then that's where we'll go. I'll call a cab. Every time I think I'm getting a handle on what's going on, things just get more complicated. It feels like we're always a step behind.
The Woodsman is the only lead we've got, and he was one of the last people to see Faith alive. Getting some answers out of him will start to clear things up.
I hope you're right. Bigby, be honest with me. Who do you think did this? I know it's still early, but I just feel a step behind. It's an uncomfortable feeling.
We haven't talked to him yet, but,
Tell me. I don't think anything would surprise me at this point.
I feel like Bluebeard has something to do with this.
I had the same suspicion.
I don't know how or why just yet, but if you're asking, this is his M.O. There's still a lot of questions. We find the Woodsman. Figure out what he knows, and go from there.
Makes sense. That's probably the best approach.
Thanks for
you. I wish there was... Sorry.
I was just going to say thanks for the help. It's been appreciated. That's all.
Of course. I'm just glad I haven't been in the way.
Far from it.
So... It's nothing. I just... Seeing all this today, there are fables that are struggling worse than I'd imagined. We pay so much attention to the residents of the Woodlands. You forget there's a whole community out there to serve. To have to turn to prostitution. I wish there was more we could do. This isn't how I thought it would be. But Crane runs things his own way.
Crane is the one to blame here, not you.
Obviously, you don't know what I do all day. Right now, I'm the gatekeeper, making sure none of these disenfranchised folks are, as he puts it, wasting his time. I'm more to blame than anyone.
You'll fix it.
I don't know. It's just a broken system. The fables who walk in through the back door like Bluebeard, we have all the time in the world for them. You try and come in through the front door, through the proper channels, asking for anything, needing help. Well, I turn you away. Now things are worse off than they've ever been.
Well, that's not true.
Right. We've had it worse, but not by much. Maybe this isn't for me. I thought public service was pure. A way to help. Maybe you should handle this one.
Yeah, maybe I should.
Bigby. Just be careful, please.
The same goes for you.